Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. Now, the last video I did was about four axle units. Those were our GPs, our general purpose. This video is going to be about the six axle engines, also called SD, and that stands for special duty. Other things you may see sometimes might be the letter C. The four axles are Bs. If you remember back in the day, those like U30Bs or B30-8s, whatever. In these engines, they're gonna be called C, and that's for six axles. So that's where you'll see your CWs and along that line. W also stands for wide body. So there's some stuff that I didn't know until I started working for the railroad. This video, like my other videos, is only my opinion. Okay, now everybody has opinions. I look through the comments. A lot of the comments, I see people's opinions from people that have never run an engine. And yes, I'm gonna call them engines. 24 years with CSX. I don't feel like calling them a locomotive. I call them engines. All right, so we're done criticizing DJ in this video. I'm telling you, man. This is going to be an engineer's opinion of these six axle engines. Let's start off with the most common one that I've had in my career. It would be the SD40s. Now, what I like about the SD40s, first of all, from a modeling standpoint, from a rail fan point, they're probably the coolest looking engines. I don't know. There's just something I always liked about them. I know Southern Pacific had those SD40Ts, the tunnel motors with like the really long nose. I never got to drive one of those, but I thought those are always really slick. So the SD40, and you know, you have the SD40s, even like the SD38s, I never got to drive one of those. But the SD40s, SD50s, you know, it's all the way up. They're EMD, electromotive division, and most commonly, they were kind of set up like the GPs, where you're facing, you're turning actually more at this angle. And so your controls are this way. Of course, you have your reverser, your independent, and your automatic brake. So this is all set up this way. Once again, your head's facing forward, but your controls are like off to your side. So it's, you know, not really the most comfortable thing. One thing I'm going to tell you is, in recent years, I noticed that these SD40s, because I had them just not too long ago on a local, is there's a lot of what I call lateral sway. And it's literally like this, especially when you're not pulling and you're not in dynamic, you're more like in coasting. It can get really bad. And I learned this from a conductor. I'm gonna tell you something. The old head conductors that I used to work with back in the day, they knew how to run an engine better than most engineers. So a lot of stuff I learned was from the old head conductors. And when you're getting this lateral sway, I mean, it'll hurt your body after a while. To lightly feather the independent brake. That's just the brake pads against the wheels. And you'll notice that the engine will stop swaying. So yeah, here's some stuff that you're not gonna find from anybody else. So the SD40s, to me, you know what they remind me of? My first car. My first car was what year was it? It was like a 1981, whatever, Chevy Citation. And when you pop the trunk or you pop the hood, it's like, here's the engine, here's where your oil goes, here's where your antifreeze goes, here's where your windshield wiper fluid. It's like, that's it. It's so easy. You know, it's not like today's car. You know, you pop the hood and you're like, I don't know what any of this stuff is. It's all computerized and stuff like that. That's what's cool about running with the SD40s. It's just so simple and so basic to start and everything. It's just like, okay, so this is this. That's what I like about it. What do I think about like the SD50s and SD70s and all that stuff? One thing that I don't like about the SDs and the GPs is the fact that when you are turned sideways, you don't have a desk, and our orders are on paper. And sometimes they're like six pages, and page one is, you know, they tell you where everything is, that there's going to be a guy working on the tracks between point A and point B, your speed restrictions, other things you may know, like there's look out for a landslide at this spot. And so we're always looking at our papers, but there's no desk. Like your heater, this is the other issue, it's like a little vent type thing, a little heater right in front of you. It's slightly angled. Sometimes you can put your paper on there. Sometimes we'll bring duct tape to tape it down, but it's not a good desk. So that's what I don't like about that style of SDs. Now, when you get into the bigger engines, and it's going to be a desktop. Now, with the desktop, all the controls are the same. You still have your basic controls. You have your reverser to go, you know, forward and backward. You have your independent for the engine brakes. You have your automatic for the air brakes. The throttle, actually, what's interesting is the throttle is this way. You go around and then go dynamic braking on here. So, you know, but you actually have more desk space. The horn is going to be a push button. It's a little square. It's like the bell, the horn, an alerter. And I've talked about the alerter in the previous video. That's there. And then your sanders. People ask me all the time, what are sanders like? Okay. A lot of times I call sanders just a placebo because in some cases, like, yeah, you know, the sand's really not helping. There are some instances where, you know, if the rail's really wet and you throw some sand down, you'll get better traction. But so that's what it's like. Now, other things, like I said, the wide bodies are going to be they're better for your body because you're facing forward. What I hated most, and I've talked about this, you know, over the years, was the dash eights. I don't think there was anyone on planet Earth that hated the dash eights. And whenever I would show up to work, now remember, we have no control over the engines. Like, well, why don't you just, you guys don't know. When we show up to work, we don't have any control over what engines we get. It's like this either is coming in on the inbound train, or if the yard master says, grab these two engines, that's not even his call. Okay, that's the Power Bureau in Jacksonville. So, yeah, we have no control. But you know, I look at my paperwork like, okay, you're getting CSX 7000, I'm like, oh man. As soon as I know I'm getting a dash 8, there goes the trip. But I think a lot of those have now been retired and scrapped, or they're just in storage. So yes, the notorious dash 8s I hated. The new engines. Now, the new engines are going to be more from GE, so maybe I'll save that for another video. I'm going to stick basically with the SD40s. How are they different from a GP? Well, of course, with the longer engine, the heavier, but you have now six axles. You're going to grip the rail better. It's going to give you more tractive effort. You guys sometimes give better explanations than I can. I just try to make this stuff as simple as possible. In the video about four axles, there's been some really cool guys that have left some great, very thorough explanations that you might want to take the time and read. So be sure to watch that GP four axle video and then look through the comments. So let's see, what else can I teach you guys about the SD engines or the six axles? Do we notice a big difference when we start going up from like an SD40 to an SD40-2 to a dash, you know, dash three? My opinion, once again, anything dash three really is just maybe a different computer screen and maybe an auto start, better toilets. That's my, you know, personal opinion. So recently I had this SD70, I think it's an SD70M. Now, I'm pretty sure that M stands for modified. I'd have to look into that. It was clean. It definitely was clean on the inside. It seemed like it had some newer components to it. I was not impressed, to be honest. I mean, I appreciated the inside, but did I notice like anything amazing? No, I really didn't. The best engines we have are those new, you guys call them Jivos. They're like ES or ET or AH or that type of stuff. Those engines are phenomenal. They're so comfortable, and they're quiet, and they pull. I mean, it is ridiculous the tonnage that these things can pull. So one question I get asked a lot about is distributed power. And that is when you put the engine either in the middle of the train or at the rear of the train. Now, I've covered this before in a really cool video about distributed power, but I'll touch on it again. We don't have SD40 set up for distributed power. At least, I know way, way back in the day, people say, oh, back in the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie days, they used distributed power. Yeah, it wasn't as good as it is now, but the technology in some form existed back then. But let's just talk about today's distributed power. That means there is not an engineer in it. And there's pros and cons that I've covered. You're not going to find distributed power in an SD40. What the company wants to do is have a big, new, modern engine with the new computer stuff, because I'm telling you, this stuff is very high tech. It's not like we just flip a switch and off it goes. It runs like 20 minutes of diagnostics and of checks and all these different things. There's a lot of safety stuff built into this. And when it works good, it works good. So you're going to find it more on the new Jivos more than anything else. And how it looks is there's a screen. We have to have a separate screen. And that's why you don't want to have some tight SD40 or GP40, because you need all these different computer screens. So it's a whole computer screen by itself, PTC, positive train control. And it's going to be lines, and it's going to show your engine and the cars, which direction it's facing, and it actually shows you where your road crossings are with a little line. And if you don't blow your horn, guess what? It blows the horn for you. I know, they're trying to get rid of my job, right? Anyway, so it'll tell you within 6 miles if there's anything coming up, whether it's a slow speed coming up, or let's see what else, a work authority, or a red signal, or end of our limits, something. It'll tell you. It'll tell you 5 miles to this, 4 miles, all the way down. And it's a really good safety feature. It really helps. So that's a whole screen in itself. Now with distributed power, there's one screen here that we set up for distributed power. And so it's going to show my lead unit. We'll say, I'm just going to make up a number, CSX 5432 as the A unit. That's what I'm running. The distributed power engine will say it's at the rear of the train. It'll say like engine B, 5678, would be the engine number. And of course, we make sure that when we set that up that it's going the right direction. It'll ask me which way is this engine facing, east or west or front or back or whatever, let me say. And so that, I don't put the engine in forward and that engine's facing the other way and we rip the train. So we go through all those things, all these double check safety features. So distributed power, two ways of doing it. The one I prefer is called mirror. Whatever I do, if I am in the first notch of throttle, that engine's in the first notch of throttle. There is a few second delay. It's not going to be too much, but we'll watch. I'm like, okay, all right, now it caught up. And if I go into braking, it goes into braking. And like I said, there's a lot of cool advantages to it. So that's the screen itself. Then I have a third screen, and that's going to be my normal screen. And that's going to have all of my, how much air is going through to the rear of the train, my speedometer. They all have speedometers too. So, and also, we noticed that sometimes the PTC screen might show that I'm doing 24, but my speedometer here says I'm doing 25. And so which one should I go by? You always go by the fastest one. Because let's say this says I'm doing 26, and this one says I'm doing 24. So I'm like, oh, okay, well, the speed limit is 25. Let me move this up one. So I'm doing 25 here. I'm doing 27 here. Turns out this one is right. I've been speeding 2 miles over the speed limit. I'm in trouble. So you always go with the fastest one. I would rather turn out that I'm going too slow than going too fast. And of course, we can calibrate it and figure out which one is accurate. But worst case scenario, always go with the speedometer that shows the faster speed. All this stuff you're getting, all this knowledge for free. And if you like this knowledge and you're appreciative, I do have the PayPal link, just if you wanted to just donate. Say, hey, Deej, appreciate everything you've done for the past 12 years, teaching me stuff that no one else is teaching and that I've subscribed. And I just want to kick you a little something to help buy your daughter Christmas presents this year. Okay, so anyway, so another thing we have on these new engines that you're not going to have on like an SD40 or the GP40s is going to be trip optimizer. And what is that? That is cruise control, right? It knows our trip. When we program it, it'll say, hey, you're going from Newcastle to Knoll. And sometimes it'll tell you, hey, you're going to arrive in 3 hours and 40 minutes if you go by us, okay? And so, yeah, this thing knows every speed restriction, because remember, we don't just go in and start pulling on that throttle. Every section of track has its speed. So trip optimizer, yes, this thing will actually go into throttle. It'll go into dynamic to make sure that it stays within the speed. It used to run really slow. I just noticed my last trip, this thing was holding pretty good. I was kind of impressed with you know, how close the track speed it kept. The goal of the trip optimizer was they think that they can save fuel by using their technology to figure out, hey, we can isolate that second engine. We can have this one in eighth notch and that second one in first notch and still give you enough tractive effort without having to burn up so much fuel. Whatever. Okay. So I know this is kind of a long-winded video. But yeah, there's, like I said, there's three screens. There's so much, the PTC, the trip optimizer, the distributed power. That's why, another reason why we need two men on the job, because there's just so much to pay attention to. But you're not gonna get a lot of this stuff on the SD40s. Every engine does have the PTC. That's basically rule number one. They want us to have PTC. Don't really need it too much, like on a yard job. You just put it in restricted mode and doesn't really care about stuff. But that is that's the difference now over the years between the SD40, where it's just so simple, just like my first car, to these new Jivos, where it's just so much computer stuff. And yes, the new engines are more comfortable. Almost all of them do have a thing up here. It is a camera, and it's monitoring me, it's monitoring my conductor, and it has a cell phone detector. We call them the sniffers. So if you have your cell phone on, it's going to detect it. That camera is going to record us. It's going to send it to Jacksonville, who will then send it to our boss, and then we get fired. So that's why I always follow the rules. I don't use my phone while working. It's just there. There is your insight on six-axle engines. And if you have anything that you want to see in the next video, you can leave it in the comments and I'll try to cover that. So yes, a very long-winded video. I don't care. This is all done pretty much in one take. And I thank you. Subscribe to my channel, DJ Strains. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram, Patreon. I can't answer every email. I have a daughter. I have a life outside of this stuff that I'm really trying to focus more on. So I just don't have the time to answer just every single email or whatever. But the Patreon always puts you to the top of the line. I try to answer you guys as quickly as possible. And also we do the Zoom calls and or FaceTime. That way I can help out my Patreons. And if you want to see, like, I don't really do the live shows, but I'm thinking about doing another live show in December. If you want to see that, great. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye.